Well, you join me right up in Shropshire for this trip, and it's absolutely beautiful up here. The countryside is really, really lovely. And I'm at Merrington Carp Fishery, which is, again, it's a lovely venue. I've not fished here for a long time, so I thought, do you know what? I'm gonna have a trip up there. As the fish are getting bigger, they're absolutely glorious as well. And we've already done the draw. I come out 9th out of 10 people, which is pretty much just standard for my drawing ability. And after a little shimmy and a shuffle, a few anglers wanted to fish next to each other, so they've moved about a bit as well, which has, you know, let me move swims from where I actually drew to where I want to be. I'm in a half decent area, I've done a couple of fish over the weekend. So yeah, with no further ado, before I melt like an old ice cream, I'm off to find the biggest shaded tree I can possibly find. This is my swim. This is peg 2. I was meant to be in peg 12 on the draw. We didn't come out very well in the draw. But the lad that was in here, he wants to be out with his mates. So he's moved out of here, and I've had a shuffle round as well. And basically the other swim that I was gonna go in was an open water swim and didn't have a lot of choice. But this swim gives me options. I've got a bit of open water, but I've also got 4 islands I can fish. And I think that's going to be the key to catching in this weather. It's absolutely ridiculously hot. And this swim just gives me a few options. You know, I can bait fish in open water if I want to. I can try a few little different spots on the different islands. And straight away, I'm just thinking like bat fishing solid bags up against these islands. There's not a better tactic than fishing a solid bag up against an island. It's absolutely, you know, it's got me out of trouble time and time again. So yeah, it's absolutely boiling. I'm gonna attempt to set this gear up in this heat, and then what we'll do is we'll have a look at where we can get a couple of rods sorted. See if we can line a fish up. I've got my house all in order and I'm ready to make a start of getting the rods sorted. Now, I've got 4 different islands in this swim, so choosing where each rod's going to go, as well as potentially fishing in open water, is going to take a little bit working out. Obviously, I'm going to get the marker rod out, get clipped up to what I think is the best spot on the islands, and get it all marked down. It takes a little bit of doing, but it's well worth it. So you know that if you just want to move a rod to a different spot or vice versa, you can just get it clipped up and hopefully get it on the money first time. Also, I don't know what the open water, what the bottom's like out in front of me. I don't know how deep it is or anything like that. There's a few bars in this lake, so there might be a bar in front of me or something, a feature that I can fish to in open water. I've seen the odd fish milling around, so it's definitely, you know, it's definitely the odd fish in the area. But that's where I'm going to make a start. There's an aerator down the bottom corner as well. I'm going to put some bait in next to that because obviously it's a key feature. It wasn't on this morning, but it's obviously on a timer and it's on now. But yeah, it gives me plenty to get on with. So I'm gonna crack the whip, get these rods sorted. If you like this content, And stay tuned, as towards the end of the video, we'll be running a giveaway for all of our subscribers. Just a quick one. When fishing to islands, I ain't got the patience to be wrapping my rods up all the time every time I want to rechuck. So all I do is put a little elastic marker on, put it next to the spool when I'm island fishing, just so that's exactly where I clip up. It's nice and simple, just saves me stood here wrapping up all the time. I know exactly where I've got to be. Prior to coming here yesterday, I knocked up a couple of solid bags. Also used the old Avid bag stems, and it just means I can loop to loop them on. This rod's already clipped up, just saves me sitting here tying bags. Great for if you're going for days only as well, saves you so much time. Well, I was getting a bit doom and gloom. I had that, put the rod out on the island, and to be honest, I didn't feel like it was going that well. I started off on a little yellow hook bait and kept getting these savage little plucks from, I don't know if they're roach or rudd. There's rudd swimming around on the surface, and they become a bit of a mare. So I wound it in and made a little change. Just put a wafter hook bait on, a bit bigger, and catapulted a few boilies over the top, just so if the rudd or the roach were blowing the bag out, then I still had some bait there and I had a slightly more resilient hook bait. Yeah, so that different hook bait was definitely the key to getting the bite. Oh, he's a nice pretty mirror. Come on then. It's definitely worth making that change. It's got us a carp. Come here, mate. Let's have a look at you. There's a nice mirror. Oh yeah, that'll do. Nice to get off the mark. Yeah, I was not struggling to see where that bite was coming from, but sort of getting bored of waiting, if you know what I mean. Yeah, took a couple of hours to catch that one, but we got there in the end. Well, there you go, lovely mirror. Off of that island on that bag. Couldn't quite see where it was, the bite was gonna come from, but made a couple of changes. And yeah, made all the difference for sure. Nice. Hopefully we can keep or get a few more bites doing that. Probably gonna put a little bit of bait on the spots as well going into the evening now. Yeah, we saved the blank, that's out the way. On to number two. Thank you very much, buddy. Well, I've just slipped that fish back and I've got no rods in the water. I want to get everything sorted. And what I've decided is, because of the interference I had on that right-hand rod where we caught the fish, I feel like there's, I don't know, some rudd or roach about, and just to make sure that I've got a bit of bait there and my bag's fishing all the time, I'm going to put out a few 12 mil bug boilies. I'm not going to put loads out, literally just a couple of spods over each rod, and then a few 11 mil pellets. This is, you know, it's dead nice and simple. I normally would stick a bit of particle with it, or, you know, some sweet corn, but I don't want to do that because I don't want to encourage any nuisance fish if they are around. This will just sit there nicely up on that shelf by the island and just wait until the carp come round, and then hopefully I can intercept them that way. But yeah, I'm going to stick two spots out over each rod, three rods out, and then I'm getting the barbecue on. It's been a long, hot day. That is the third rod in place. They're all on the dance floor, as they say. And to be honest, I got one thing on my mind, and that is food. It's been absolutely sweltering. The heat has now dropped a little bit. I'm starting to feel a rib. I think this cameraman's gonna die of starvation as well. So yeah, we got a couple of cold drinks on ice and a barbecue to be had. Let's get it on. Nice common. Yeah, nice 20 pounder. Just before first light, that island rod went again. Yeah, after I topped that spot up on the side of that island, put that bag over the top, basically had a barbecue, chilled out, knowing that the rod was in position. And this nice common come around the corner, and yeah, we got one. Nice. Tell it's going to be absolutely baking today, so I'm pleased to get a couple of fish. Ideal. Lovely. I'm going to have a coffee now, I think. Actually, wake up. Have got four different sizes in their transfer bag range, the first being the size 5, which I would say is probably my favorite size. Absolutely love this size bag, especially for making a nice small compact bag for doing things like I like doing, like fishing long range. Absolutely bang on for that. The size 6 bag, which is the second size, is slightly longer in length, so it's ideal if you're fishing with like slightly longer hook lengths, or you just want to cram that little bit of extra bait in the bag. The size 7, which is what I class as a medium sized bag, if you're fishing with like larger pellets, if you just want to put that little sort of, you know, some broken up boilies, 4, 6 and even a few 8 mil pellets in that bag as well. It's absolutely perfect. It gives you a nice, really nice round solid bag, you know, and you can get a decent amount of bait in there. And then the size 8 bag, which I class as like probably a large bag. Now this is perfect again if you were, say, fishing with like whole boilies and you want to put some of them in there. So you could, like, say, drop your hook bait in there, for example, a little bit of pellet just to protect your hook bait. Then you could cram whatever you want in there, 10, 12, 15 mil boilies, cap it off with a little bit of pellet and then tie your bag. It'll give you a really nice large parcel of food. Not only that, I think that this bag is great when fishing with, say, like bait boats or baiting spoons. You can make a nice bag with a nice whatever size rig you want in there as well. And you know that when the boat drops or you tip the spoon over, that when that big bag, all that bait is just going to be in a large pile of bait. Everything's going to be presented really nicely. And what I like about these as well is you actually get 40 PVA bags, opposed to sort of most PVA bags, you get 20 or 25 bags in a packet. These, just bear in mind that you get 40 PVA bags in a packet. So you get a large amount of bags, last you a nice long time. You can do a lot of fishing with them as well. So just a little closer look at my exact setup that I'm using for this session. If you're wondering for a good starting point for a solid bag rig, and I've got the long flexi ring bag stem. I've got a 3.5 ounce inline groove bag weight there. And I use a slightly heavier weight just for fishing up against islands so it doesn't slip off the shelf. I've got a 20 pound pin down hook length, a size 6 Armorock curve hook. And then I'm either fishing a little 10 mil PB pop up on there, or I'm just using a little small barrel wafter hook bait. I'm putting all this inside a size 5 PVA bag, and I love using a little small mix of pellets. This is the mini crayfish mix, and in here I've got pellets from 2.3 mil down to pretty much dust. And this makes a really nice compact bag that's nice and solid, and that'll break up lovely when it goes and melts on the bottom. Absolute stonker today, roasting hot, and it's been quite uneventful. Yesterday we've seen a few fish in the area, and today we haven't. We've seen hardly any life at all, but the evening's drawing in. It's a little bit more bearable now, and I'm gonna get these rods sorted for the evening. I'm gonna make a little change. I'm gonna put one rod, there's two islands out to my left, and I'm gonna put one rod to the left of the island tonight. There's a little hole in this side of the island that looks like it needs a rod for the evening. Just try something a little bit different. But yeah, like I say, it's looking a little bit more favorable now, but it's been pretty grim today. But I'm gonna get these in, get sorted out. That is the last rod in position for the evening. I've had enough of the heat. It's been absolutely scorching. Can't blame the carp for not feeding. But if they're anything like me, I'm getting a bit peckish. I'm absolutely Hank Marvin, so I'm off to put the barbecue on. And hopefully the carp will feed not long after that. earlier in the video, we mentioned that we'll be running a little giveaway. And if you would like to be within a chance of winning these four packs of bag stems, one of each bag stem that we do, then all you have to do is like the video, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and in the comments, leave what you think is my favorite size transfer PVA bag, which I mentioned in the video when we're talking about the bags. And you could be within a shout of winning these to get you up and running with your solid bag fishing. Well, that's me done for this trip. It's been a bit of a slog. We've still managed to catch two fish despite the weather being up against us a little bit, and that just goes to show that a good solid tactic like PVA bag fishing will always get you out of trouble and catch you a fish or two. Make sure that you're subscribed if you've liked the video for any future uploads, but most importantly of all, make sure you enjoy your fishing.